So for the kitchen brigade, we're essentially talking about the system in which all of the duties and all of the responsibilities in the professional kitchen are all organized and outlined. So Escoffier is credited with developing this system of hierarchy. And so we're going to go over the classic, which is more in line of the time of Escoffier, and then the modern and what we use now. So the modern kitchen brigade, this is essentially an executive chef, which is supported by a sous chef, chefs in different areas, a line cook, maybe a separate pastry chef, and then you can have some apprentice or some short order cooks. And this is really going to be determined by the menu, what the restaurant serves, and how many positions are necessarily needed. So the classic kitchen brigade, this is a chef of the cuisine, and this would be supported by the sous chef. And then you have something called an expediter. If you work in a restaurant right now, you may be familiar with the term expo or expediter. And sometimes an expediter is one of those positions that's both front and back of the house. So I know when most of the places that I worked when I did expo, I wasn't preparing the food. I took the plates after the tickets had been set and I garnished the plates. I set them, I set the trays, and then I made sure that they had a runner. So whether that was myself that ran them to the tables, or I found front of the house staff. And some places actually have kitchen food runners, and that's their entire job, is to just run food. And sometimes you utilize different servers. Depends on the level that you're working. You know, when I would be working at a higher class place, they may have a food runner that's hired, and when I worked at Applebee's, it was pretty much up to the servers. We didn't hire a separate person. So if you look at the Escoffier brigade system and how it breaks down, you can see that each area and each position really had there's a lot of different types of cooks, and these terms here are really describe what they cook. So if you look over here, if you can see, like under the saucier, you may have the poisonné, which would be the fish cook. You have a couple of undercooks under them. You have a butcher, and then you may have the meat cook and the butcher, the grill cook, fry cook, the potager. The potager dealt with soups. Legumier, they are doing more with your vegetables. And then you can see you have a pastry cook, baker, a decorator, and these positions were very formal. In the modern system here, you have a little bit different of a breakdown, and you may end up having people that don't work as many positions. So the modern kitchen brigade, it just kind of fits the modern kitchen. The dining room front of the house is also organized in a brigade. And so typically the dining room manager is going to be the one that's going to lead that. And again, that really just kind of depends on what level of restaurant you're at or you're working at and how formal that service is and is going to be. So a more formalized breakdown is potentially going to have a different person for wine, for beverages, for taking orders, for seating. So it just kind of depends on that level. So what does it really take to be a professional chef? Being a professional chef, ultimately, work ethic is going to be the number one key. So this is not the type of position that you work because you want to get rich or you think you're going to get famous. This is definitely something that you feel in your heart. There is a lifelong learning associated with becoming a chef, and the learning never stops. The development of new trends and new foods and new ways of preparing things, it never really ends. And so there's a lot of knowledge base. The terminology, the technique, the science, it's very deep, and every single subject, every single chapter that I teach, not only is it in depth, like when you begin to open up your textbook and you see all of the vocabulary associated with each chapter, it builds on itself. And so for me as a teacher, it's really important to understand that my students really have mastered and really understand that content before I can go on and before I can really cover the next. So it's also difficult for me sometimes to know where do I start, where, because there's so many things that you have to know is with that foundation. So knowledge of tools, knowledge of terminology, recipe skills, safety and sanitation, mise en place, those basic knife skills, understanding the equipment, understanding the positions in the kitchen, all of these things really, really are key and are critical. And it takes a student who is humble, who recognizes and understand as you work with individuals that you have something to learn from everyone, that you're never done and you never stop growing and you never stop developing. So, walking into the classroom or the kitchen, it's always every day going to be a learning experience. You need to be open to that. And no one knows it all. I deal sometimes with people that do think they do, but nobody knows everything. We all have something to learn all the time, every day. I've learned things today just in planning a lesson that I've taught for my students many times, and I still was able to learn something new today. So, and the skills develop with experience. Cannot stress enough how important it is that you just continual practice and continual practice. That becoming a master of the craft, it takes hours upon hours upon hours of work. So when you see a chef pick up a knife and whip through and do these beautiful chops and everything is specific and everything is precise. That is hours and hours worth of work that you're looking at there. And nobody, this is not a born with thing. This is a developed thing. Having taste is important as well. So being able to taste and discern that. I've known people that they choose not to smoke or drink hot drinks because that is going to impact your taste quite a bit. Hot beverages, and cigarettes or and vaping, these hot things in your mouth are going to kill those taste buds and it's going to alter your taste as well as your olfactory glands. The professional ethics and the pride, you need to be proud of what you're doing. You need to be motivated to want to kind of move forward, but you also have to work with other people. So with professional ethics, we're really talking about being honest and fair and having integrity, avoiding conflicts of interest or misuse of the money, not discriminating against others or engaging in sexual harassment, having worked in a kitchen environment, before the beginning of the Me Too movement, I can say that there's a lot of sexual harassment involved towards women and a lot of inappropriateness and knowing those lines and those boundaries of like who you can joke with and who think what things just aren't a joke and you so you may not even necessarily mean it, but it's important to just kind of keep those boundaries between yourself and others. Making sure that you're accurately representing yourself, your work, and your accomplishments. You're not producing food items and claiming that they're yours when those recipes really belong to someone else. Supporting other people as well. You're growing together and you're part of a team. You may not like all of your team, you may not like all of your supervisors, but knowing how to control your emotions and be professional in the environment and working with those other people is really, really important in the culinary industry. So there's a lot of career opportunities. Everybody really needs to start at the entry-level positions, and the more of those positions that you work, the better you're going to be at all of them. They all intertwine. And so somebody that has only ever been a pastry chef really just isn't going to understand what a line cook goes through, and somebody that's only ever worked back of the house really isn't going to get the frustrations of front of the house, and same thing vice versa. So, the more positions that you can work, the more that you can work your way up, the better it's going to be. There's a lot of focused areas: garde-manger, pastry, butchery, roundsmen that kind of do everything. Developing recipes, food manufacturing, test kitchens. Being a personal chef in a private home, the cruise industry, travel, working in college food service. I know like even here in Lexington, most of the fraternities and sororities have a personal chef that works there. I think generally during the summer times, they're not.